Today I'm going to show you how you can use the IF statement in VBA. Now this is one of the most common statements, one of the most useful statements in VBA, because it comes in really handy whenever you want to build in some type of logical thinking inside your macros. The IF VBA statement is actually very similar to Excel's IF formula. The way it works is that you tell VBA what you want to happen if a certain condition occurs. And you can have many conditions. You could have some conditions that have to be true, that have to apply together, or some conditions where you want something to happen if either of those conditions apply. So this is where you can work with the AND as well as the OR functions in VBA. So let's start off simple. What I'm going to show you first is how the IF function works on its own, and we're going to base it on one single cell. Once we get that to work, we're going to apply an IF condition to a range of cells. So basically, we're going to loop through them. First, let's bring up the VBA editor, Alt F11. I'm going to insert a new module. Just click anywhere, right mouse click, insert module. Okay, by default, it's module 1. You can change the name down here. The sub, let me just call this simple if. In the first simple if statement that we're going to do, I want to copy this number in B9 to C9 if it's greater than 0. Okay, so all I have to do is type in if my number is in range B9 dot value, if that's greater than 0, then I want to copy it to C9. So I'm going to use the assignment statement here, and I'm going to say range C9 dot value equals range B9 dot value. Okay, so you see I used if here and then. Now, if you have everything in one line because you just have one thing you want to occur after you typed in if, then you can leave it like this. You don't need to close the statement with an end if. But the moment you have more things happening, so let's say we wanted to change the color of this, we wanted to add a border to this, then we need to break it up like this and then type in an end if on the bottom here. Now let's try this. I'm going to press play. We're going to see 45 in here. Now, if I put this to a minus 2, let's just remove this. Let's bring up the editor. Actually, I'm going to snap this in, so I'm just going to drag it all the way to the side to fix it. This way it doesn't disappear all the time. Press play here. Nothing happened, right? If I put 500 here and I press play, I get 500 here. How do we bring AND in here? We do it on the first line. So right here, I'm going to add an AND. What's the second condition that I want to happen before I copy this value? Well, let's say I want the value to be between 1 and 400. So I'm going to make sure that range B9 dot value is less than or equal to 400 before I do that. Okay, so when I press play, this number shouldn't appear here. It doesn't. Now, if I have 399 and I press play, it appears. And for 400, it should appear too. Okay, the OR function works in the same way like the AND, except it checks if either of these conditions apply, and then it copies your data. Let's now expand on this and loop through this range and look for these different conditions. So let's do sub if loop. That takes us to task number 2. Here we want to highlight cells between 1 to 400 in green. This means we need to loop through this, which means that we need to find beginning of the range and end of the range. And there are many different ways you can do this. You could fix the range. You could dynamically find the end of the range by using Excel down, or going the other way by going to the bottom of your workbook and doing Excel up, or looking for the current region. There are many ways, and I cover them inside my VBA course. Now, I'm just going to show you one practical way here, and that's to use table referencing. I'm going to convert this data set to a table. So just click anywhere inside and press Ctrl T. The table has headers, so I'm going to say OK. And the first thing I do is I go and clear the style. So it takes me back to my own style. And under Design, which is a tab that pops up there, because this is a table, I'm just going to change the name to Table Sales and press Enter. Now, I'm going to use this range here. So if I just go to any cell and type in equals, and I highlight this just to get the syntax that I need, I'm going to copy and paste this in there. Now, in the cell, it tells me value because obviously I have a lot of numbers here. It can't show them in one cell. But the moment you put this inside a formula that can handle the different values, you're going to see the numbers. But I don't care about this actually. All I want is this syntax, which I copied. I'm going to remove this and go here. Now, I want the macro to look through each cell in this range. I have a video on the for each statement. I'm going to link to that below this video in the description. First, I'm going to dim my variables. I'm going to call this cell as a range. Now I'm going to use my for each statements. For each cell in my range that I copied, so that's going to be range, quotation marks, I'm going to paste what I copied, close this with next cell. Now our task says highlight cells between this. Here we need our if statement, right? Because we need to check the value of each cell. The value that we're checking is actually what we did right here. So I'm going to copy and paste this right here. Instead of fixing the range to this one specific cell, I'm going to do cell.value, and for this one as well, cell.value, right? So when you see it in red or you get some pop-up message saying that it's invalid, that means that there's something missing. What is missing? Then. So if you have an if, you need a then. I'm going to close the end if. End if is like closing your brackets when you type in the formula. Now, what do we want to happen? We want the cell color to be green, right? So that's cell dot. Now the color property belongs to the interior object, right? And that's something that I also cover in my course in detail about how to find these relationships. You can see that clearly in the object library of VBA as well. So cell.interior.color equals, we can dig into the library and get VBA's constant for green, and we can get to the library by typing in VBA dot. It's in section color constants dot. Now we see the colors. There is our VB green, right? But these colors aren't really that fancy. So let's just take a look at how green works. I'm just going to press play and you can see this. It's a bit too bright. Now what I normally do is I pick my own color. So let's say for green, I want this one, right? This is a much nicer green. To find the color code for this, what you can do is use the immediate window. So I'm going to go to view, bring up the immediate window, and I'm going to query the color of that. So notice that my cell is activated. Now I'm going to go to the immediate window, put a question mark, type in active cell dot interior dot color, press enter. That's the code I need to get this green. So actually I'm going to change that to this nicer green, right? So let's just run that and we get the nicer one. Okay, so that's a simple if then statement. Now let's do something more. Let's make another exception. We want 1 to 400 to be green, but everything else should be yellow, right? So let's bring up a nice yellow in here that we want. So I'm going to go with this one. Now, all I'm going to do is press enter to get the code, which is this. How do I bring that in my if statement? I use the else. You're probably familiar with Excel's if formula, right? Whenever you start writing if something, then this, otherwise this, else is the otherwise. All you have to do is type in else and tell it what you want to happen if your first condition doesn't happen. And I want this color to happen. So I'm going to press play and everything else is yellow. Let's make this a little bit more complicated by adding in another condition. I want any negative values, I have one here, to be red. Everything else yellow, what we had before should be green. So 1 to 400 green, negative red, everything else yellow. Let's come up with a nice red color. Let's go with this one. Now, this cell is active, right? So I still have my statement there. I'm going to press enter. That's the color code I can use. Where do I bring it in? I have if and else. So before the else, I can add an else if statement. And right after that, I need to put the statement for what it should check for. So I want to say if cell.value is less than zero, right? So if it's negative, then I want the color to be this 192. And notice the else if statement also needs the then. So don't forget the then. We're going to add in cell.interior.color equals 192 here. Okay, so now we have an if, else if, basically if the number isn't between this but it's minus, do this. Otherwise, for everything else, do this. So this means that this one should become red when I press play, and it does. Okay, so that's how you can use the if statement, that's how you can loop through a bunch of cells, and that's how you can use the color code that you want to use in your files in your VBA statements. If you like this video and you want to learn more about VBA, make sure you check out the complete course. That way you can learn it in a structured way. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel, you like what you see, you want to improve your Excel knowledge, do consider subscribing.